this is Jewel Lever with the Cayman Compass. I'm here with Mr. Denniston Tibbetts, who's running Cayman Democratic Party in the district of Red Bay in the May 2017 elections. Mr. Tibbetts, please introduce yourself and tell us why you're running for the Legislative Assembly.
Well, thank you, Jewel. I'm Denniston Tibbetts, and I'm running for the constituency of Red Bay in Georgetown. I'm a fifth generation born Caymanian. I had the honor and the privilege to be educated in Jamaica. And when I came back home, I worked at the Public Works Department for a while, and then I formed my own company. And I'm also a happily married man of 46 years, the father of two adult daughters. I have one grandson, and he's the apple of my wife's eye. But I'm running because I see that my country, which I love dearly, is going downhill very fast. And I have thought about running for a long time, but what is happening right now in the community has made me make the decision to run. So I know I can make a difference because I've been involved with community work all my life. So I'm asking for the chance to represent the Red Bay District, or the Red Bay constituency, I should say, in the district of Georgetown. And I'm a member of the Cayman Democratic Party. Thanks.
What's the most important issue facing your district?
Well, I think the most important issue that's facing my district and most districts in the Cayman Islands, or Grand Cayman, I should say, is that people are falling through the cracks. People are losing their homes. And the Democratic Party has a policy that when we are elected, we will change all that. We will put in place different things that will enhance the life of people. And we also intend to help the Royal Cayman Island Police in their effort to fight crime. Because crime is a big thing in the district of Georgetown, and more so the Red Bay district, the Red Bay constituency. We know and we believe that we can make a difference. That's why we're planning to assist the Royal Cayman Island Police in their efforts to stop the deterioration of the society on a whole. Thanks.
What's the most important issue facing the Cayman Islands as a whole?
I think the most important issue facing the Cayman Islands is education. We have to do something about education. It is not... It's difficult for me to explain. What has happened over the years is that we have gone back in time, you know. This is a modern society and we need modern techniques of teaching. And you know, my youngest daughter is a teacher, and she moved here to the United States to teach because she was so dissatisfied with what was happening here. The education system has to be looked into, and also the immigration system. We have immigration laws that we believe are not conducive to assisting Caymanians, and Caymanians, in our book, should be first. That is not to say that we can't work with foreigners, because foreigners is what we know that helped develop the Cayman Islands. But our people, the Caymanians, have to come first. So we are going to, when elected, we are going to institute different things, different new immigration laws, and also we are going to assist with the teaching profession to make sure that the teachers understand that they have to teach and not just be there for a paycheck. So we need to enhance education and the immigration system. And I think that's the most important thing.
What is something that Cayman is doing right, and how would you help to continue that?
Well, it is our humble opinion, and definitely mine, that at the present time, the Cayman Islands government is doing nothing. So we have to step up to the plate and give the Caymanian people a want to be who they are. And we're going to introduce different policies that enhances the way of life. We're going to introduce different community-minded policies for the elderly. We're going to help, help the Royal Cayman Islands Police enforce. You know, people talk about laws, changing this and changing that. I believe we have enough laws. We just need to enforce them and make sure that they are adhered to. Because our country right now is so divided that we don't need that, you know. We are retracting instead of going forward. And the Cayman Democratic Party, which includes me, we plan to change all of that.
If elected, what's your top priority on day one?
Well, I would like to rephrase that. When I'm elected, I, with the Cayman Democratic Party, our first thing and my first issue would be education. Because without education, we're nowhere. I mean, we as a whole, as a people in the Cayman Islands, and people should realize that education is paramount to everyone. I mean, if we don't have education, then everybody grows up ignorant, you know. People are leaving high school now that can't read and write, and that's not acceptable. So the first thing would be on my agenda is to enhance education, and also to assist with the planning laws. I mean, the builder's law, which they're trying to, I'm not sure it's all finished yet, but that has been in the making for 10 long years. And it's just a law. Why is it taking so long, you know? I think the main reason is that when the present government took over, they just threw away everything it was the United Democratic Party at the time, that they had put in place. And that is wrong, you know. We have to continue things that are good. So in addition to all of the things that we have planned, the top priority for me would be education and the builder's bill.
Mr. Tibbetts, thank you for coming to visit us and for answering our questions. We think this has been a great opportunity for the voters to learn more about you and your candidacy. Once again, this is Julie Levy with the Cayman Compass. Thank you for watching.
And thank you too, Julie. Pleasure is all mine.